Here we go, 10 things Star Wars Battlefront 2 players hate about capital supremacy. Hey everyone, it's Andrew. Some of the points on this list might cross over with the last video I made, but I thought this could be a good opportunity to flesh them out a little more and see what you guys think. Okay, so number one, there is only one map. As fun as the game mode was when it first came out, after a few rounds of playing capital supremacy, it becomes very obvious that this game mode needs more maps. Don't get me wrong, I love Geonosis. In fact, it's probably my favorite sand planet in the Star Wars galaxy. Yes, I like it even more than Tatooine. Why? Because it really commits to being a sand planet. There's sand on the ground, sand in the sky, sand in the mountains, sand formations, and a race of hilarious bug people who talk like this. But there's only so much time I can spend on Geonosis blasting droids and shooting clones before I feel like it's time to move on. Which leads me to my next point. Number two, capital supremacy is repetitive. Now, I think a huge part of this feeling is to do with the fact that there's only one map, but when I spend 10 to 15 minutes on the ground running between command posts, desperately trying to fight off the invaders, and then get flown up to a capital ship for another 10 minutes just to get slaughtered and drop back off on the Geonosis surface, only to repeat the whole process another two times before either team finally wins the battle, I feel like I could be using my time more effectively. For example, by assisting with the droid attack on the Wookiees. Ki-Adi Mundi was right. Everyone always forgets about the droid attack on the Wookiees because they're too busy fighting off waves of droids on Geonosis. Number three, there is no drivable ATTE. One thing I think is great about Geonosis in Galactic Assault is the fact that the entire match heavily revolves around the use of the ATTEs. They are fun to drive, have some decent weapons, and are pretty tanky overall. However, for some reason, these aren't included on Geonosis in Capital Supremacy, and can only be seen as destroyed vehicles making up part of the rubble of the map. My question is, if this vehicle has been designed and programmed and built for Battlefront 2 and is drivable in another game mode, why not give us some sort of variation of this to play with in the non-linear game mode that is Capital Supremacy? I miss this. This was the good stuff. Instead, we have AAT tanks, which I'm pretty sure weren't even part of the Battle of Geonosis, along with Staps, ATRTs, and speeder bikes. I think it's still cool all these vehicles are here, but the fact there are number four, vehicles you can see but can't drive, frustrates me in a way I'm not okay with. By seeing these spider walkers, hailfire tanks, and dwarf spider droids all animated and walking and firing their weapons, I'm made to question why we would be teased with the possibility of being able to actually see these vehicles come to life without being able to operate them. I want to slowly scuttle my way around the battlefront firing this big dish laser. I want to uncontrollably roll and fire off my purple homing missiles in all directions. I want to dance side to side and stare into the helmet of a helpless clone trooper with my red merciless eyes. We could be doing all of this, so why aren't we allowed to when they're right here? Number five, no airships or LAATs. In a previous video, I saw you guys didn't like that I was saying LAATs instead of LAAT, so I'll say LAATs from now on, I promise. I see LAATs here. I see LAATs here. I even see LAATs here. So why, when LAATs were the most pivotal vehicle used to save all the Jedi and win the Battle of Geonosis, why, when that's the case, are they usable on other Galactic Assault maps on other planets, but they're neither flyable or functional on Geonosis? Instead, we get these, destroyed remains of what could have been. These are literally the crucial vehicle for the Battle of Geonosis, and they're not even available as a reinforcement. Number six, no ground-to-air combat. Alright, yes, the Battle of Geonosis was predominantly fought on the ground. However, there was still a major part of the battle fought in the sky, with the transportation of thousands of clone troopers in LAATs to the front of the battle. Now, the fact that Capital Supremacy is a two-tiered game mode, the first phase fought on the ground, and the second phase up high in the capital ships, what would fulfill so many players' cravings for space-to-ground combat would be if they combined Phase 1 and Phase 2. How about you spawn on your own capital ship, jump in a starfighter or LAAT, fly down to the planet's surface to complete an objective, then fly back up to the enemy's capital ship to destroy their system core, or whatever it's called, the core of the the ship, the thing that blows up the ship. Now, I have no doubt that this type of air-to-ground combat will one day become a thing. But whether it's with Star Wars Battlefront 2 or a future Star Wars game, who knows? But there's so much fun still to be had in the Star Wars universe that I refuse to believe this type of game design is impossible. Like I mentioned in my previous video, this is already a reality as a PC mod for 2005's Battlefront 2, and for a game that's nearly 15 years old, it looks pretty impressive. Bringing this all back to Capital Supremacy, I believe this mode at least needs some type of aerial combat to mix things up a little and add some more variety and dimension to the gameplay. Let me know if you agree. Number 7, the game doesn't load properly. I touched on this briefly in my last video also, but in terms of immersion and feeling like you're in the game, if there's a sudden super obvious texture loading issue or the game just doesn't quite function like it should, it pulls you right out of that Star Wars fantasy pretty damn quickly. This one here is pretty damn obvious and makes the transition from phase 1 to phase 2 of the battle feel more clunky than it already is. Also, the design detail in both hangars is pretty cool and feels authentic to the film, so it's a shame to not be able to show this off in the cutscene. Also, sometimes there are two transport ships that spawn here instead of one. I mean, two is better than one, I guess, but like, come on. Number 8, the command posts are all the same. Another thing I briefly discussed in my previous video. The general consensus I've received from a bunch of my friends and other people that play Battlefront 2 is that on the Geonosis map in Capital Supremacy, all the command posts feel like they're placed just in random spots outdoors in the Geonosian desert. There's very little variety between command posts, apart from some being up on a hill, others being on flat ground. This one's next to a destroyed HAVW A6 juggernaut. They're all just random spots of land chosen as location for a command post for no obvious reason. What's the point of capturing this command post? It's not like it's the enemy's hangar or a control tower or anything significant. It just feels like a random patch of land on Geonosis. I think this is another reason for gameplay becoming repetitive. There's just not enough variety in the actual objectives. In my last video, I compared the Geonosis map from the Conquest game mode in the original Battlefront 2 to this map, and noted how the variety in command post locations made the old game fun, exciting, and varied. That variation is what the Capital Supremacy map is lacking. Number 9, no playable Geonosians. Everyone's favorite bug people in the galaxy are flying overhead, waving down to all the clones and droids in the battle. However, they never land or come down to say hi. You can't interact with them, you can't shoot them, you can't play as them. Just the same as Wookiees play a role in Kashyyyk, so too should Geonosians play a role on Geonosis. And it'd be great to play as one, just like the old days. I want to be a bug person. Number 10, there is no change in match conditions like there is in Galactic Assault. Alright, let me explain. What I think is so fun and immersive about the Galactic Assault Geonosis map, and why I honestly think it has one up on the Capital Supremacy map, is because of the change in match conditions halfway through the battle. First of all, based on the stage of the Galactic Assault battle and where you're up to in the match, the landscape you're fighting on is very different. The first half of the match is much narrower, with lots of rock formations, cliffs, hills, and difference in scenery. The second half of the battle becomes a very open, spread out, chaotic encounter where weather plays a part. That's right, I'm talking about the sandstorm.
Storm's coming up, honey. You better get home quick.
This changes the match conditions drastically and always keeps you on your toes, because even though you know you're fighting in a very spread out location, the storm prevents you from being able to see too far in any direction, creating unpredictable encounters and fast decision making in fast changing battle conditions. It's exciting! Now, in Capital Supremacy, there's no dust storm and no real big changes in landscape or match conditions throughout the map, apart from the physical change in scenery moving to the capital ships in the second phase of the battle. Capital Supremacy is a game mode that deserves more variety. If it exists in Galactic Assault, why can't it exist here? So what do you hate most about Capital Supremacy? Is it still the lack of droidicas, or do you absolutely love the game mode? Let me know in the comments. And go check out my 50 insane details in Capital Supremacy video, where I discover details such as this battle droid hanging off one of the missiles of the ship. Imagine if they fired that rocket, he'd go flying, it'd be amazing. Also, how cool is this? My friend Evan built this. He's studying to be an electrical engineer, but he's recently decided to dedicate his life's work and knowledge to Bombastic. Thanks for watching, guys. My name's Andrew, I'll catch you soon.
Stay bombastic.